we had been talking for a while about Bad Bunny and how like incredible his music is and how it reaches across so many different styles of music. And then he came in the office to play his record for a big group of us who gathered in the conference room. And I mean, it blew us all away. It's one of those moments, you know, when an artist makes a really big statement. And that day is when we decided, all right, we got to do a Bad Bunny cover. And we actually told him in the room in person that day. And so when we started talking about photography, it became, well, how do you do it? You can't send a photographer there.
We realized that we were going to have to figure out a more creative way to shoot him. And when I spoke to his team, I asked if there was anybody with him who could, you know, take the pictures for us, basically work with us. And they were like, yeah, Gabby can work with you.
We made pizza yesterday, like homemade pizza.
We started talking about how they spend their days, and they're playing games, and they're getting suntans, and they're making cocktails, and they're listening to records. And we were like, oh, well, that's how we should shoot it.
The way it turned out, we couldn't have come up with anything better than what we did, because not having a crew there, not having publicist or manager or hair, makeup, actually allowed them to have fun with it and take these pictures and sort of document what their days are like in isolation. I actually didn't want to give too much direction because I wanted it to be real and to kind of reflect how their life was. And I think she captured it perfectly.
I was nervous at first. I thought obviously it was gonna be a very cool photo shoot, but it's difficult for me to accept that it's gonna be the cover for Rolling Stones, you know?
Yeah,
it was not planned. So it was very random. It was just like taking pictures, like a usual day, really. I can tell him, do this, do that, and he can tell me, no, let's do it this way. So it was like more like a team.
In a way, it turned out to be a gift, because you would never have been able to capture those sort of intimate moments except this way, because his guards are completely down, you know? He couldn't be more comfortable with anybody else in the world. Would I have ever imagined that Bad Bunny would be on the cover of Rolling Stone with a mask, you know? No, but she did an amazing job. I'm gonna share the cover. I think we've waited long enough, right?
Me encanta. Oh, yeah.
Qué bonito.
Qué brutal.
Wow.
No parece ni que es del iPhone. I love it.
Thank you. Gracias.
Felicitaciones.
My mom is gonna cry.